Hey YouTube, I'm back with another deck profile videos. Haven't done one of these in a while, but I still will be doing these videos. In this video, we're going to be doing a deck profile on Dark Magician. So I haven't done a Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck profile or even a Yu-Gi-Oh! Video in a very long time, number of years actually. So this is going to be kind of like a retro deck profile video or a throwback to back in the day when I started the channel with the Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck profile videos here. So we're going to be doing one on my Dark Magician deck with the updated Dark Magician deck, because I had to do this because there were a lot of people requesting this on my Twitch live streams talking about Yu-Gi-Oh! And what happened, what's the situation with Yu-Gi-Oh! Why I don't play it anymore. So I did actually come back to play briefly last year at the end of the year. I rebuilt Dark Magician because I found out about all the new Dark Magician cards and the movie was coming out and all that stuff. So I got back into the game briefly, but I got back out of it, but I still have the deck, so this is going to be it. So this is my Dark Magician deck. As you can see here, I have the Figma Dark Magician girl here and the Yugi, Yami Yugi one. If you want me to do like some kind of overview or review of the Figma video or like the action figures in separate videos, you can let me know and I may try that. I do have not a super collection of Figma, but I do have some of those, so I can do those if you guys want to see the type of content on this channel for the gaming and hobby section. So, to start off, we have three of Dark Magician. He is the main bread and butter unit of the deck that makes it function. This is my original Star Deck Yugi trial deck, or actually starter deck, Dark Magician. And then we have the Legendary Collection one. I think that's what it was from. And then we have the one from the Yugi Gold Edition. This one, the second artwork of him. There's a few other ones, but I don't have... These are the three different artworks that I have. I think I have another one. The Arcana one. I have the red one from the... I forgot what it was called. It's the... It came out a while back, but not too long ago, but I have that one. But anyway, three Dark Magician. You have to run three. It's a must for the deck to function. Next, two Magician of Dark Illusion. It's like the Shadow of Dark Magician. A lot of people run three of this for competitive builds. I would agree with that. I would actually bump them up to three. I do have a third one, but I'm not using them right now because I do want to showcase some other old fan favorites, such as this card, which is my favorite card of all time, the Dark Magician of Chaos. It's unbanned, I know. That's actually one of the other reasons why I came back to the game briefly. But Dark Magician of Chaos, he's really good. He's like the big boss monster that can come out and really mess with the opponent for a while, and then he gets you back a card, he leaves the field, and things he destroys are removed from play, he gets removed from play when he leaves the field. So one of him, and that's basically like the really big monsters. Then moving down the stack to Dark Magician Girl. So I have my Legendary Collection Yugi's World 1, which is like the original art, the one that Yugi used in the show. So two of her, because she allows you to go into the rank 6 monsters as well as get your Dark Magician Girl, the Dragon Knight fusion summon out. So we'll talk about that in a little bit. So two of her, it's pretty good at 2 copies. A lot of people just run one, but if you only run one, then you won't have access to rank 6. But one is probably enough if you want to run the 3 Magician Dark Illusion. Next, for the engine of the deck, we run 3 Magician's Rod. Again, this is definitely a 3 of if you're focusing the deck on Dark Magician. There's another build that's focused on just the Magicians or Yugi's Magicians in general, which would use the new Magician Girl cards like this one. So I'm running 3 Chocolate Magician Girl. She's probably the best one out of the Magician Girls that came out for the new Dark Magician and Dark Magician Girl support. So 3 of her, because she helps you also like get stuff out when she's attacked. So that's, yeah, 3 of her. Next, we're running 1 Lemon Magician Girl and 1 Berry Magician Girl. There are other ones. I can, in the future, make a deck that does showcase all the Magician Girls. But then it wouldn't really be all that focused on Dark Magician. It would be more like a general purpose Yugi's Magician type of deck. So that's it for the monster lineup. As you can see here, those are all the monsters I'm running. We'll move on to the spell cards. get these out of the way. Next, for spells, probably the most expensive spell in the deck, and it's the one that actually makes the deck really competitive, Dark Magical Circle. So I knew from long ago that someday Konami would make a card that would make Dark Magician, would finally propel him to the top, and this is that card. This one, and probably there's a trap card in here also, but Dark Magical Circle is the card that makes the deck actually work. It makes Dark Magician tournament level capable. Yeah, so this card's amazing. It's a continuous spell, but you need to run three of it because it's that good. Next, I have all the other Dark Magic cards. So one Dark Magic attack, it's basically Harpy's Feather Duster. One Dark Burning attack. Because I do run two Dark Magician Girl, because Dark Magician Girl's in here, you can benefit from using this card. Basically, what it does is if you control both of them, Dark Magician and Dark Magician Girl on the field, destroy all cards your opponent controls. Literally just blows up the opponent's entire field. So it's like another Raigeki plus Harpy's Feather Duster in one. Whereas Dark Magic Attack is your Harpy's Feather Duster when Dark Magician's on the field. Next we have Dark Burning Attack. Because I run two Dark Magician Girl and she's relatively easy to get on the field. Not as easy as Dark Magician, but kind of not that hard. If you control on the field, destroy all face-up monsters your opponent controls. So it's basically a lightning vortex for Dark Magician Girl. So I can run it at one because I have Dark Magician Girl in the deck. Next, one Dark Magic Veil. Pay 1,000 life points, special summon one Dark Spellcaster monster from your hand or graveyard. So this is extremely good at reviving any of the like monsters, like for instance, Dark Magician Girl, Dark Magician of Chaos. If you like discarded him into the graveyard, meaning he didn't like leave the field, because then he'd be removed from play, or Dark Magician. So usually this is kind of like a good monster reborn to get all the Dark Spellcasters, and pretty much all of them are dark except for the Magician Girls. These three, they're not dark. But yeah, one of those is basically like Monster Reborn. Then one Dark Magic Expanded. This card is a very interesting, unique card, and it works with the number of Dark Magician and or Dark Magician Girls on the field and in the graveyard, so it counts all of them as they stack up. But it applies additional effects based on the number of them. So if you have one, your Dark Spellcaster monsters on the field get 1,000 attacks till the end of the turn. So it's kind of like a spellbook of power. That's the way I think of it. And then it has the second one where you have two, and your opponent activates cards and effects in response to your spell trap cards. You can it prevents the opponent from activating in response to your spell trap card. So that's actually pretty cool. It's kind of like a Forbidden Lance, sort of. I can't think of a better example right now. And then if you have three, then monsters you currently control are unaffected by your opponent's card effects until the end of turn. So this is really good also at going for like a late game push, so they can't mirror force you or any of that sort of stuff. And it's also a quick play, I forgot to mention that. This is a quick play, so is Dark Burning Attack, which is amazing. Next, Dark Magic Inheritance. Banish two spell cards from your graveyard, add one spell or trap card from your deck to your hand. That specifically lists Dark Magician or Dark Magician Girl on it. So basically, this is your searcher for any of the, like, any of these cards. It also can search this card. I'm running one, the Eye of Tamias. So the Eye of Tamias is in here, so you don't need to run polymerization, and allows you to go into your fusion monsters that you're running. We'll go over those shortly, but yeah, that's why Eye of Tamias is in here. Then one Typhoon, one Raigeki, one Book of Moon. And those are the others, the non, like, specific to the deck spell cards. They're kind of like generic spell cards. Next for the traps, three Magician Navigation. This is almost also one of the most expensive and most important trap cards for the deck. Magician's Navigation along with the Dark Magician, Dark Magical Circle, well, whatever, you get the idea. They're like the must-have for the deck to make it function. Yeah, really, really needed to have three of those. Next, another one that you could get away with running two of, but I am running three for good measure, Eternal Soul. Again, this is another way to get Dark Magician back from hand or graveyard to the field. And then you can also, it's like once per turn you can activate one of those two effects. The other effect is add one dark magic attack or 1,000 knives from the deck to the hand. 1,000 knives is also pretty decent at one of in here, but it's too hard for me to decide what else to take out. If I wasn't running Dark Magician Girl, I probably would run 1,000 knives, just because. Then one dark renewal. One is enough, really. Like, at first I thought it was amazing, but one is really enough. And then one Magician's Defense, which could be cut from the deck. It's not all that good. It's slow, and it's easy for the opponent to get rid of. But it's a decent card for, like, a casual build. Like, if I was going to make this at a competitive deck, I definitely probably would not run this. I'd probably run, like, another Dark Renewal or another, like, spell card or magic card. I mean, not a magic card, a monster. Then one Call of the Haunted, just a generic monster revival card. One Mirror Force, because Mirror Force, and one Starlight Road, because this deck is very spell trap heavy on the back row with all like the stuff like Eternal Soul. You kind of don't want stuff like this to blow up, because then you lose all your monsters. So Starlight Road is usually in here to protect Eternal Soul. So, and yeah, so that's basically the main deck. We'll go over the extra deck real quick here. For extra deck, I am running the one Dark Magician Girl, the Dragon Knight. So she is a card I pulled in an unboxing video a long time ago. Never got a chance to use this card until now, at least not competitively. One Amulet Dragon, same deal as the Dark Magician Girl. So Eye of Tamias gets these two out. It also does get this card out, Dark Paladin. So I'm running an extremely rare Dark Paladin that I've had for many, many years now. And I'm so glad that I'm actually finally able to put it to good use with this deck. So Dark Paladin, he's also a really good target for Eye of Tamias. One Stardust Dragon for Starlight Road. It's just an annoying, pesky card. You can, like, negate with Starlight Road, get him out, then use him to negate something else, and then he's gone. But really pesky card, decent stats. One Ebon Illusion Magician, so now we're getting into the Exceeds. So Ebon Illusion Magician is really good. He's one of the better Exceeds for rank 7. We also have Ebon High Magician. I don't really go into him as much as the other one, but he's pretty good. One Big Eye, my Big Eye, I've always used this. One Draco Sack, I almost never use this in the deck because it's not really needed. So those are like the rank 7s. And then, of course, the Stardust. Then we have for rank 6, for Dark, because I'm running 2 Dark Magician Girl, I can go into Photon Strike Mauser or Nobito, the Moral Leader. So it just depends on the situation, the opponent I'm going up against. One is Spell Trap heavy, the other is Monster Effect heavy. And then for rank 4, because I can, but I almost never, ever make a rank 4. I have Gaga Cowboy, because if you just need to kill the opponent with burn damage, he's in here just for that. Alchemic Magician, because there's good spellcasters that can go into that, but it's very, very, very rare. Almost never make this. I probably wouldn't use this. I'd probably put like a Zen Mains in or something instead. And then one Downer, she's easier to make than that one, but very situational. Abyss Dweller is also kind of situational in here. It's hard to make this card, and so is Silent Honor Arc, number 101. So that is my Yu-Gi-Oh! Dark Magician deck profile. Hope you guys enjoyed this kind of like retro deck. I haven't done one of these for Yu-Gi-Oh! In a long time, because I don't actually keep up with the game on a daily basis anymore. I consider myself like a retired Yu-Gi-Oh! Player at this point, but I thought I would do this because it was requested on Twitch. So hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks.